Good stuff, yeah, see you out there. I see you on the ocean floor. I see you swimming out there. You swimming with those hearts. I know you like it out there, but I don't know what to say. I see the singings out there, but hey, it's a great day. Under the sea, under the sea. You can eat pizza, say I'm cold or whatever. It's good to me. You going out there, going to sleep. I say, hey, you stupid creep. I just get it under the sea.
Hey, hey,
under the sea.
Check it. I'm gonna make it worth your while. Chat.
What?
Chat. $20 super chats. And Abu will go and I'll go see Barbie. How about
wait, that? Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Slow down, wait.
Let's call. Listen, call him all the way out. Because you said you wanted to go with Lorena.
Yep.
Let's keep it real, bro.
You're gonna disappoint me like that?
No, wait. Okay. Let's start over.
Stand up for your word, bro. Don't be ashamed.
Yeah, stand on it, bro. Ain't nobody gonna judge you. If you want to see it, see it.
Pictures. Abu has to wear the plastic Ken wig.
That's right. He has to have the plastic fro.
No, not the fro.
No, I'm not doing that. Him, not
no,
doing
he's got to be real Ken, not black Ken. I want to see the actual with the comb over and all that stuff. Yes, you, Abu.
That'd be dope. I want to see that. I want to see that.
You got one of your closet anyway. Stop hunting, bro.
Wait a minute. How would I picture the whatever the head thing that I'm supposed to be wearing, Mark? Because I don't have an idea.
Oh, there you go.
What the hell is going on?
Yeah, you have to wear a pink shirt.
Oh, hell no.
Yeah, bro. Yeah.
That's it. You love.
Abu, you okay?
No, I'm not okay.
We'll just keep going for it.
I'm gonna take your daughter.
Anyway, now that we at the I am contemplating mysteries of the universe as to why and how did I get tricked into this. Shout out to the Lord Commander, Demogeni. I'm gonna get you for this, bro.
Oh. Hi, my name is Fatal J. And I'm not just a fat freaker to eat chicken nuggets and Sam Cola. I also sell comic books. You can go to this website right here. It's called Kickstarter. And what you can do on this website right here is you can help me to give you comic books. Now, as you can see, right now I'm at $78. But by 24 hours, I want to get to $500, which is my goal. We can do it. We can do it. If we did it the first time, we'll do it this time. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to look through the rewards that we got going on Kickstarter. This is what you can do and help me out. What we got right here, look at all that beautiful art right there. You know what I mean? Beautiful art that's already done. The book is done. You don't have to wait on me. All you have to do is get me to the goal. And guess what, ladies and gentlemen? Boom, I'm printing and shipping to you. So this is what you can do. Cover A, $12. You got cover B, $12. Cover C, $12. Cover D, $14. Cover E, $15. Now, something very interesting. It's something very interesting about this right here. Bosco, I'm supposed to blow your mind. Bosco is a guest back in the background. Bosco, can you believe it or not, YouTuber Robert Storm made this cover for me, and he killed it. Ladies and gentlemen, make sure to get that, because guess what? You're not going to see that cover anymore after this campaign. Let's continue. Cover F, $18. Cover G is the wraparound. The whole cover, front and back, that's the $20. Get that special edition. You're not going to see that no more. Best believe. Next up, we got this is the speciality of it all. Got half a chicken nugget right here. Let me finish real quick. So I can really get in my mode. And thank y'all for coming out to the Dark Council show. Make sure to smash that like. So, Ninja Blast cover A. And inside this one, what makes this one so special, inside this, you get 5 pages of preview of Ninja Blast 2 inside that bad boy right there. You're going to want to get that. You got cover A signed by me, Fatal J. You get all covers for $100, which is a steal, ladies and gentlemen. And then you get all covers signed by me for $125. Help your boy, Fatal J. In 24 hours, I believe we can get to $500. We did way bigger than that last time. $500 is easy work, okay? So y'all support that in the comments below. Or description below. Make sure to hit that. I almost said description below. I know they clowning and laughing me in the background, but I don't care. I don't care. Okay. In the description below, hit the Kickstarter like and get your boy 500 of them things before. What's today? Wednesday? Before Thursday hit. Well, Thursday at 12 o'clock p.m. time. Before that time hit, get your boy Fatal J. I'm begging and pleading. I want to give you guys dope stuff, okay? Now I'm done shameless plugging myself. We got a guest in the back right here. Bosco!
Scenario in the house. Thank you for having me, man.
If y'all don't know about Bosco, let me tell you something. Bosco is a real true ninja. Because if you had a live stream, he was in there. Best believe. Bosco, tell him about yourself before we get into the show.
I got a small channel called The Bosco Scenario right now. I do a show every Wednesday at 8 p.m. called The Hangout. We went a little bit earlier today because I was graciously invited to your channel. So, yeah, man, check us out every Wednesday, 8 p.m. We have a great crew there every Wednesdays, bringing it to you. And gaming sometimes on and off. So, yeah, man, thanks for having me.
Bosco, let me tell you something. That Spider-Man poster that you got on your wall right now.
Yeah, it's a puzzle.
Never invite me over. Because I'm one of them. I'm one of those type of guys.
That come and take something?
Well, I was one of them guys when I was little. I would say, can I borrow that? I'm like, come on, man. You don't even play with it. And in my mind, borrow means it's mine.
For it keeps. Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a few
fun. So, Bosco, we're gonna be talking about a lot of things tonight, man. And I want to hear your opinions about it. It's some wild stuff we're going to be talking about. But we got the dark council in the background. We got the Majinai. We got Mark with a C. And we got the drunk one right up in the building.
Great. Hey! Hello. Hi.
Here.
What's up, everybody? Everybody?
Hello, everybody.
Did you hear
breaking news right now?
How about you be quiet for a second? Because
you got the touch, you got the power. Yeah.
Now you
put
talk.
The yeah in there. Good.
Yeah.
Shout out to Mike Has Bad Knees. He gifted 5
big shout. Members,
gifted 5 dope people out there. Dark Council, how are you doing today? How are you feeling?
I am good. Doing okay. I am doing wonderful.
Are you talking about that? There's an extra white person on the panel today.
No, see how you think. That was a shout out for Dawn. Because when you do the clip in the beginning, one of Dawn's super chats come up. It says she wanted me to do the Andy Kaufman because I did that in one of my videos. So that's why she was requesting it. She thought it was so funny.
So that was for Dawn.
Never yeah,
I love you.
Shout out to Dawn. Shout out to Zachariah. Sounds shout like... out to Chris Caron. Shout out to Netflix. Shout out to Bosco. Shout out to Christine. Christine been supporting Dark Council forever, and she been supporting Drunk 3PO forever. I remember Drunk. She was the first person to buy one of your first shirts and take a picture.
Sweet.
She got.
Yeah,
that
she's title. Amazing, man. She's amazing.
Yes, she is. Let's continue. We got Renee up in here. We got Taylor Swift, greater than Disney, Star Wars, and MCU up in here. Thank you for coming. We got Kai up in here. We got Dark Shadow up in here. We got Dylan up in here. Dylan Soup. We got Anik Jones up in here. We got Amanda up in here. We got Heisman up in here. We got Chris Caron in here. Chris Caron, thank you so much, Original Jedi.
Yeah. What?
Chill Mugga, what's up, man? I'm glad you're here, man. I just want to tell you something, man. I just want to say I love you. Pause. Let's continue.
Oh,
we got Daryl the Dialect up in here. What up, Daryl? We got Eldrick up in Derelict. Here. What up, Eldrick? Who?
Daryl the Derelict.
Well, you know I can't read and spell.
Yeah.
You know I can't
read. I got your back, bro.
I think I got everybody. First time ever in life. All right, fellas. How was work?
Rainy and trash.
Good.
Not a liberty to
say. Yeah. Yeah, up here it was damn near a tornado. So it was pretty bad, man. Wind and rain and trees flying all over the place.
We had tornado warning too, and it was like they almost shut down Disney World. So that's pretty wild. Yeah.
We got a what snow up, watch up here.
Tonight on the Dark Council show, we're going to be talking about different topics. We're going to be talking about Marvel has their Silver Surfer, but it's not the person you think it's going to be, nor the gender. We also going to be talking about X-Men 97. We're going to give our reactions. We're also going to give our reactions to the Black Girl Gamers drama. We're also going to be speaking about, and we're going to react to Good Times reboot on Netflix. So we got a bunch of great things to talk about. A bunch of
great things.
It's a bunch of splendor and luxury that we're going to be speaking on tonight. Also, we're going to be speaking on stuff.
Okay. All right.
What up, panel?
Kill it, baby.
But this is what we always do. This is starting to be a tradition that I made up on the show. This is what we're going to do. This is called Would You Rather. I wanted to wait till Lorena came on the show. You guys want me to wait? Bree, we're not going to wait.
He enjoys
it. We're not going to wait. We're going to keep going. Bosco, this is a game that we play. It's kind of like, you know, training before you get into the actual game. You know, warm-ups. This is a warm-up right here. This is called Would You Rather. What we're going to do, we're going to go around each person. And it's easy to play. You just pick whatever it tells you to do. You got two options, okay? Are you ready?
Hell yeah, let's do this.
We are ready.
You guys let me know if y'all can hear this.
First one, would you rather eat a raw egg or drink a cup of vinegar?
It's on you, Bosco.
I would rather eat the raw egg.
Gotcha. Oh yeah, and it's gonna get harder too.
Would you rather swim in a pool of mayonnaise or a pool of syrup?
Give me syrup. Syrup for sure.
Syrup.
Would you rather lick a public toilet seat or lick a stranger's sweaty armpit?
Oh, God. Holy crap. What? Armpit? I ain't thinking no toilet seat. No.
Okay, would you rather wear the same pair of socks for a week or the same pair of underwear for a week?
Is that you, Drunk?
Socks.
Drunk is on.
Would you rather drink spoiled milk or eat expired meat? No, I can't.
Spoiled milk, easily. I used to do that back in the hood with cereal.
Nice.
Would you rather eat a raw onion or a raw garlic clove?
Raw garlic clove. Give me the garlic. The best antibiotic.
Would you rather drink a cup of seawater or a cup of dishwater? Oh, come on.
Dishwater?
I know. It's like a toilet or something. A plunger.
Now, would you rather fly land on your food or a cockroach crawl on your bed?
Whoa. Fly on the food. Get that all the time over here anyway.
Would you rather smell someone's dirty socks or someone's dirty underwear?
Socks.
Okay, I don't even want to know.
Again with the socks.
They keep giving him socks.
Yeah.
I'm trying to say something?
Trying to tell you something, bro.
Would you rather have a runny nose or a dry throat?
Dang, that's both messed up, but I'll take the runny nose, though. What? There's nothing you can do with a dry throat.
Would you rather never shower again or subscribe to my channel? Okay, this one's way
too easy. Okay, that's
easy,
too
right?
easy, Bosco. We're going to skip this. That's too easy, man. You got the next one, Bosco.
All right.
Would you rather get spit on by a llama or get peed on by a puppy?
I'll take the spit of a llama. Already happened.
Continue smashing like. Would
you rather shit yourself or vomit on yourself?
Vomit.
These questions, guys.
Vomit. Yeah,
he already pooped himself once.
Shut up.
Hey.
On camera.
You know what? You know, hold on, man. Hold on. I'd rather...
Don't say it. Don't say it.
Would you
don't say it.
Take a bite out of a bar of soap or a shampoo sandwich?
Oh, yeah, a bar of soap. What the hell is going on?
Like, who comes up with this?
So, would you rather kiss someone with really bad breath or hug someone really tight with really bad body odor?
Probably hug.
Oof.
I don't want that stuff in my mouth.
This is the last round.
Would you rather have wet socks for the rest of your life or never shave or cut your armpit hair ever again?
Bro, let me tell you why this is hard. Because my pet peeve is wet socks, bro. So I seriously don't know.
Let it grow.
That would be easy then.
No, man, because my wife don't like that all up. You know what I'm saying? It's already bad enough. I got chia pets on my chest and back, bro. I'm like a werewolf.
Bro, easy.
Dang, that's a hard one, bro.
Okay, the rest of us get 3 seconds, man. Keep it moving.
All right, man. I'm sorry. I'm going to let it grow. I can't do wet socks, bro. I just can't.
What?
I can't do wet socks. It's
Would you
torture.
Rather eat something out of the garbage can or eat something off the floor? What would you do?
Eat it off the floor.
Wasn't that my turn?
Would you rather use someone's spooky face mask or use the exact same towel every day?
Wait, whose turn is it?
I'll use my own towel.
No, I didn't go.
Or use the exact same towel every day.
That was on me. Yeah, I said the towel. I'm not using.
Now it's Mark.
Okay.
Would you rather have bird poop fall on you or step in dog poop? Did this ever happen to you?
Yeah, I've had both. I hear bird poop is good luck, so I'll take bird poop.
Would you rather have a pimple on your face or a mosquito bite on your face?
Oh, what's so saying is?
Would you rather
have a spoonful of cinnamon
or a spoonful of mustard?
I don't know whose turn it is. Remember the cinnamon
challenge?
It was your turn, bro.
All right, man. This is over, man.
I messed up.
So Fatal messed it up by taking 10 minutes to answer one question.
I know, right?
He cheated. Threw the whole thing off.
He pressed pause and everything. He like, what should I do?
You need another chicken nugget to get you going, man.
Bro, I would expect that from Demogeni, but not you. I'm disappointed.
Why I got to get that?
I think I'd rather get slapped in the face than wear wet socks for the rest of my life, bro. I hate socks. Well, I hate socks that's wet, and I hate socks. This ankle. Well, ankle
you would have been PO today because my socks got wet in that rain today. I was
bro,
mad.
But what's
I
the
hate when my socks yeah, get
it was
wet.
Rough.
Do anybody on the panel like wearing ankle socks though?
I've worn them.
You in like wearing
what's
wrong?
Ankle socks?
That's better
like low cut ankle or yeah, completely like
crew socks.
I'm talking about them joints that's under your ankle.
Oh, the little
depends on the shoe
things. You just cover your I'd rather not.
Okay,
that's for my tan line.
You wear the joints. So you telling me you wear the joints that's above the ankle, like above the ankle bone? You wear those short ones? Mm-hmm. I don't like them either. I gotta have long socks, man.
You like those 1970s?
I can't do long socks anymore, bro. Who does that?
I gotta have socks to go all the way up past my calf, bro.
Like a cholo.
Bro, he
past your calf.
He walk around with thigh highs on, bro.
That's what it sounds like, dude.
You got New Balance on and you be grilling.
You got thigh highs on.
They make me feel comfortable. I feel safe. It's like a security plan.
Safe from
what? Something you want to tell us, Fredo?
Bro, you know how everybody got something that make them feel safer? Socks, long
socks.
Long socks make you feel safe, huh? Okay,
make me feel safe, man.
No judgment.
You stick your money in the sock. You stick your money in the socks too.
Up to
okay.
Your thighs. We were kids.
Chat, don't make me seem like I'm the only one crazy. I'm also the type when I'm sleeping in the bed, I don't hang my feet outside of the bed. And the reason why I don't hang my feet outside of the bed is because something might grab my foot.
See, Fatal, I get that if you had like a cat. If you had a cat, like, well, I remember when I had a cat, my cat would always try to catch your feet. I'm like, nah, I can't. That's why I don't do that.
I got a cat, but he's not allowed in my room. But this is what I'm saying, bro. I can't sleep if my foot is outside the bed. Like, you know how some people sleep wild and their foot is hanging out the bed? I would never be able to sleep because I'm thinking the whole time something fits to grab my foot, like an arm under my bed or something.
You scared of the boogeyman, bro? Let me find out.
Who? Like, something happened to you as a child? You need to get off your chest?
What's going to grab your foot?
Exactly.
Bro, I don't know what will grab my foot, but in the back of my mind say, put your foot back in the bed, bro, before something grabs it.
But if it grab, like, you think something's strong enough to pull you, a grown man that likes to eat, pull you right out of bed.
If something grabbed my leg when it's outside, I'm screaming like a bee, bro. I don't care how much of a grown man I am.
And so you keep your legs, like, you keep your leg like under the covers? Is that what you're saying?
My leg is under the covers and it's not hanging outside the bed, bro.
What about your arm? What about your arm? Do you keep your arm inside? Do you think your arm is going to get grabbed or?
My arm, I don't really worry about my arm, but it's something about my foot and my leg, bro.
Heard about those people that wear them, have them weighted blankets. They sleep with like blankets that weigh like 25 mm-hmm. pounds.
Yeah.
Because it makes them feel secure while they're in bed.
That's true, bro. Because my grandma made me a quilt, and I can show you if you think I'm lying.
Man, my grandma's quilt, I feel like I'm cooking in an oven, man. Them things.
They don't make them like that no more.
It could be negative 10 degrees outside, and I feel like I'm sweating like crazy.
Yeah, man. So shout out to all the people out there, you know?
If Count Dracula comes in, he's not going to bite you in the foot, though. He's going to bite you in the neck. Do you keep your neck under the covers? I mean, do you think about these things? Or
bro, Count Dracula is so evil, bro. He'll bite me on the leg just to mess with me because he know that's my fear.
Never heard. Somebody got
a call. All right, man, let's talk a different topic, man. Thank y'all for coming out to the Dark Council show. We're going to be talking about some news, some MCU news, and I'm glad the Marvel boys are here, right here, right now. This is breaking news, ladies and gentlemen. Julia Garner has been cast as a female Silver Surfer in Fantastic Four. So all them people out there that were saying, yeah, we got Fantastic Four, they supposed to take over the game.
No, what are they doing in that picture?
They're
what's
surfing.
Going on
together?
In the nude. Oh my!
This is celestial bodies.
Like they having fun to me.
This is a failure. I knew it was a failure when they put Pedro Pascal in there. He is not Mr. Fantastic. First off, he's too. It's certain actors you see. There's too much of them. That you only see like you can't see them in that role because they just. Oversaturated. He's one of those guys. That was a kilter for me right there. And this, put a chicken and make a lame and gay. That's what that is right there. They haven't learned anything. They haven't learned anything. Keep doing
Bosco,
it.
Bosco, you're a Marvel here, right?
Which one? Yeah, I wasn't much of a Silver Surfer following, but I get why people are upset because Silver Surfer is the more well-known character. Like yes, I never knew about the woman character before until like
It's a woman Silver Surfer.
Yes, out there? It's what we call they're not gender bending it, right? She's not. It's she's actual a character in the comic books.
Oh, so this is in the comics.
The girl that is female Silver Surfer also has a few other identities.
Gotcha.
So I don't think she's gonna be. I don't know that much about the female Silver Surfer. I don't think she's as powerful as the regular Silver Surfer. Someone can correct me. But I believe that she has different names and personalities as well. So she was like one person, and she changed, and then she like I believe I have to do some research. I don't know that much, but kind of like. Turned into the Silver Surfer on accident, I think. I could be wrong.
Gotcha.
Okay. So
let me ask the Marvel boys out here because this whole panel is Marvel boys. I'm secondary Marvel boy. Are anybody excited about Fantastic Four, especially here in this news right here? Anybody excited? Do you think this is gonna turn Marvel around from the trash, garbage, hot boo-boo, hot trash movies out there?
Nah, man, I'm over it.
Doubt it.
Yeah, me too.
I'm over it.
I mean, if they give us a crazy story and it actually works out story-wise.
It's gonna take place in the 60s, I believe.
That's the only good thing, I think.
From what I read is that, yeah, it's gonna be like way in the past in its own little universe. So they should have done this after Endgame. They should have just like paused on the Marvel stuff for like a few years and then done a Fantastic Four universe with Galactus, Silver Surfer, Dr. Doom. They could have pulled in that's how they could have pulled in the X-Men, things like that, if they wanted to do that. The biggest issue that I think I'm nervous about is that the Deadpool film is going to be a multiverse film, which could bleed into the Fantastic Four film. So that's how they're going to connect everything with like Deadpool's like going to like possibly connect everything, which is kind of weird because Deadpool should be just a standalone, you know, like it's like its own little thing. It's like,
well, John,
the universe, but not a part of it. I don't know if that makes sense. So
John, you usually spot on when it comes to your predictions. Do you think Deadpool is going to hit A billion in the box office.
No, it won't hit a billion.
Okay, no. Do you think it hit close first to a billion?
The first two films didn't hit a billion. Maybe with Hugh Jackman as Wolverine might bring some people back, but I think they have really hurt themselves with the nostalgia stuff. And it's just kind of like, I just think so many people are just over it. You know, it's just like, that's all they know how to do now is just nostalgia. Hey, look who's coming back. Like, you know, they when the Marvels came out, it was like the Beast. Hey, you might see the Beast. You might see X-Men in the, you know, in the Marvels. It's like nobody cared. It's like we don't care anymore. So they're just doing it. They're just doing it incorrectly. So I don't think it'll hit a billion. I would be shocked. I could be wrong. But I would be shocked.
Do you think it'll turn Marvel around, though?
No. The reason why Deadpool's not going to do well is because it's going to have, like, you're going to have seen, like, Loki 2, which, who has really seen Loki? Like, the Disney Plus show. It's because it's going to have those, it's going to have a lot of people that were in the Loki series. So now you're asking people to do homework, and as soon as you do that, you've already hurt your movie right then and there.
Yeah.
So people are going to be confused. They might leave the theater just like, yeah, it was funny, but I don't know, you know, and stuff like that. And then apparently the last rumor from Deadpool, again rumor, is that they're just going to have three or four different types of Wolverine. Mm-hmm. So we're going to see just a few different Wolverines. You know, while he's going through the multiverse, which is what? I hate the multiverse, man.
I hate the multiverse too. One of the rumors too is Henry Cavill is supposed to be one of the Wolverines. That's what I keep
hearing.
But are we supposed to be hyped about that? Because I'm not hyped about that.
I think it's stupid.
I really do believe fatigue. When people say superhero fatigue, comic book movie fatigue, it's only comic book movie fatigue because it's the same old story. It's the same trick.
Well, that's the thing. It's like it's not a good story. It's Henry Cavill might be in. Go watch it. You're going to see Wolverine. Go watch it. It's not like we have a great story that fits the plan and what we're doing. It's just like there's going to be some surprises. We're going to have some cameos. Go enjoy it. So it's like it's just kind of weird.
Yeah.
They shot themselves in the foot with the cameos with Multiverse of Madness.
Yes.
That was okay. The
100%.
So
okay, hold on, bro. I love that movie. Hold on, D. I love that movie.
You I love that movie? That was straight trash.
Man, I love that movie. One of their best movies. That was one of their best
Doctor
movies.
Doctor Strange.
Bro. Doctor Strange was tight.
With American Chavez, Doctor Strange is a zombie giving a motivational speech to American Chavez on how she can do this. They had like this power. That all it took was a little sword to destroy this book. Are you freaking kidding me? The thing was as powerful as like Infinity Stones, and that's it. Oh, give me a break, Fatal. Come on, man.
He took the piano keys, the piano notes, and we're fighting them with the piano notes. That wasn't dope. That was dope.
But that wasn't the story. That's scene, all that is smoke and mirrors to make you go, look at the pretty lights.
here's what I want to say about that. Silver Surfer thing. So there have been other heralds of Galactus that were female, right? You could have done that if you wanted to do that. The problem is Silver Surfer is more known as Norman Rad. That's who everybody, when you think Silver Surfer, you're thinking Norman Rad. So, yeah, you can have different versions of Silver Surfer. Cool. But who's the most popular one? And why would you do that when you're introducing, when you're trying to bring in the first family of Marvel? You're trying to bring them in with, like everybody said on the panel already, that should have been done right after Endgame. You should have just rebooted from right there, just went ahead with it. So you're trying to bring in the first family of Marvel Universe, right? And then you're going to put not Silver Surfer in there. Like the Silver Surfer that everybody knows. Come on. Like, yeah, sure, it's in the comics, and that's going to be the excuse. Yes, it was in the comics, but is that the most popular one? Like, X-23 is in the comics. She exists, but is she Wolverine? No. That's the problem. And they keep leaning on it. Oh, yeah, it was in the comics. Guess what? The people who are, oh, yeah, it's in the comics, you push those people away to do this stuff.
Well, it's just like they did with Shuri. It's just like they did with Shuri in Black Panther.
Yes.
Just exactly. Because she was a character that existed in the comics, but that was almost after about 50 years of lore and adventure. It's like, why are they skipping over the stuff that made them legendary in the first place? There are so many incredible stories that you could be adapting to the big screen, but they're going to jump all the way over that to come up with some characters that were just conceived of probably in the last, 10, 15 years. Yep. You know, I am so hurt by this, because I think I've said a million times the Fantastic Four was the first comic book that my mom put in my hands. I love that title. Yeah, and I've been waiting my whole life to see the definitive Fantastic Four. You know, Reed Richards is not Pedro Pascal. He's just not. You're wasting my time. I'm getting old. I'm dying, man. It's like, I want to see this. The definitive Fantastic Four before I close my eyes for the last time, and they keep bullshitting, bro. It's like, come on.
Mark, you right, though. Pedro Pascal, I know you talk about you being old, but they didn't think this through. Pedro Pascal is up in age as well. So how are they going to continue with him when he going to start looking old as freak as Richards? Because Pedro Pascal is what? In his 50s? I know he ain't in his 40s.
He's just not him. He's just not Reed Richards.
Yeah, I agree.
Regardless, even if he was 20 years old, he's not Reed Richards.
But Mark, let me play the advocate real quick. Do you think he'll be able to perform at a top-notch level?
Oh, I was about to say, ask his wife. I don't know. But yeah, as far as being Reed Richards, yeah.
He ain't with no women.
We can talk about that. But no, I mean, listen, it depends. If they go in for an audience that just doesn't care, then as usual, there are going to be some people who are going to say, that was great. You know, but this thing comes with a fandom, and they're ignoring that. It comes with people who are faithful to these characters, you know, and you're just turning your back on us for these newbies who will just take whatever, just like with, once again, with Black Panther, with Shuri. Oh, it's the greatest thing ever. It's Black Panther, man. You can't have Wakanda without T'Challa. Like, what are we talking about here? You know, but this is what they want. They want these new fans.
One more thing.
Which are not the ones consuming, like, the material or the source material. Right.
Bosco, how you feel about this? How you feel about Fantastic Four? Don't listen to us. Don't listen to the
council.
How do you feel about
this? I've always... Sorry, go ahead.
No, go ahead, bro. You got it.
I've always said it. Like, when they casted Pedro Pascal... yes, he's Chilean. Yes, he's I'm Hispanic. Yes, I was great for another Hispanic getting a role, but I'd rather see someone else play that role, because I don't think, like Mark was saying, you think of Reed Richards and it's not him. He doesn't personify Reed Richards in any way. So, and you like, it's saturated. You've seen him in what was the Wonder Woman movie as well? You've seen him there in a superhero movie.
Yeah,
I don't know.
He's Mandalorian, The Last of Us.
Exactly. So, is he a good actor? Yes, the man can act. Nobody's taking that away from him. But I just don't think that was the right person to cast for this at all.
Isn't it, Bosco? I'm glad you're here, brother. It's just mighty funny. You hear black, you hear white, you hear Hispanic all say the same thing. We don't care about this race swapping. You know what I mean? We just want to see some dope characters that we used to read when we was 7, 8, 9, 10 years old. You know what I mean? We don't care about representation. We just want you to stay true to the comic books. Now, I want to ask a question. This chick right here, I think her name is Julia Garner.
Mm-hmm. From Ozark.
She looked more Sue Storm than the other chick they think. They should have made her Sue Storm, in my opinion. Now, is she a great actress? Is anybody familiar with her?
I just know her from the Ozark. I know her from the Ozark.
Everyone says that she's a pretty decent. So,
yeah. I mean, she played well in that role in the Ozark. But that's
right. She the girl in she the waitress.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I only seen like the first two seasons, then I dropped it. But it was a dope show. She you know what? She's a great actress. She stole the spotlight in that show. Yeah. Would you say so, Bosco? Or would you say
No, she was great in the show, especially in she is like she's She's vicious in that show as well. So you see different spectrums of her character throughout the whole seasons, right? So she can act. But the question is, now, what's the story?
You can't really tell from these pictures. What's she working with, man? I mean, is she stacked? Is she, I mean, what's going on?
Not much.
No?
No.
Because, I mean, we're in the age
not
of...
Sydney Sweeney, put it that way. No. She's not.
That's what I was going for.
Yeah, nah. She
hold
not
on, hold on, hold on. Let me check. Hold on. All right, I seen Ozark, bro.
No. Exactly.
Yeah, be careful, Fatal. Be careful, bro.
It's like,
well, I think
you see, gonna... Miss Fatal come with the cane, like Sandman.
Easy, easy.
I come with the cane.
Yeah,
he's on the drop. They're gonna put her in a bodysuit. So,
what's wrong with never mind?
CGI. They probably want her a little flat.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because you see, those going mystique, on there. Those mystique days in X-Men are long gone. When it comes to Marvel now.
Yeah. Gotcha.
I was hoping that we were turning a curve. I mean, corner.
Nah. You know,
Miss Sweeney.
But hold on, I thought they learned their lesson with the Marvels, because didn't Brie Larson was wearing the white beater? I mean, excuse me, tank top. Wasn't she wearing the tank top?
Yeah. For like 3 minutes.
So maybe they're trying to get back, you know, trying to capture the male.
I don't think so. Disney today won what they got what they wanted in their board of directors fight, and it's the same crew that's been in charge, so nothing's changed. And it was kind of embarrassing, actually, because usually they take calls from the stockholders and they just used AI questions. It was embarrassing.
Wow.
So until there's a change in leadership, it's just, it's going to.
So Nelson Peltz didn't win, is what you're saying?
Nah, he lost.
He lost?
Hold on. I don't. Look, yeah. Didn't I tell y'all I rode the short bus, had rubber boots on and a helmet? And when everybody was exchanging classes, going to different classes, I stayed in one class for 8 hours in school. So I don't know what the freak y'all talking about, okay? Now, looking at this right here, Walt Disney stocks. I don't know anything about stocks. What does this mean, drunk?
It means people are unhappy with the decision that was made today. And they're getting rid of their Disney stock because they don't have any faith in the company. Gotcha. So the company is losing its value. When a stock dips, it loses its value. So that's usually what happens. Disney was a company where you could invest in stock. So like Disney was a company, if you had like 100 shares of stock, they would pay you like 35 cents a share every month for investing in the company. And the stock would go up because the company was doing well. When it's not doing well, it doesn't have value anymore. And they stop paying people that own their stock. So people dump it. They're just like, what's the point of having it? Right. So they don't want it anymore. So the value of the company is just it's dropping and people. So, all right, I'll break it down really easy. So let's say the stock was at $100. You own one piece of the company. So I bought one. Right. So now I own a piece of the company. When the company's building and it's going well and it's doing great, that piece of the company, the value starts going up. So now it could be worth $200. So I could sell it because people want it. They want something with value. And I just made $100. If I invested $100 and it starts going down and it's only worth like $25, it's like, let me just get rid of it because it's like, it has no value anymore. Nobody wants it. Nobody wants to buy it. So that's the issue. That's what's happening, right? The decision that they made today was like a painful one, honestly. It was basically, at the end of the day, it's just more the same. That's basically what they did today. So it's like more the same.
My question is, of course, this is more to it than the movies, right? The movies and Disney Plus and all that?
It's everything. Right? It's theme parks, movies, Disney Plus, their IPs that they own, Star Wars, Marvel, Fox. all that stuff. So it's all put into one thing.
Gotcha. Now, speaking on stocks, and I wish Lorena would come on the show, and I don't know what the freak this mean, but this young lady, how you say her name? Chicole?
Chloe?
Chloe? Oh.
Chloe Cole.
What's wrong with you, bro?
Bro, I don't... What did I say?
Those Chicole? Nuggets, man. Eating too many of those nuggets, bro. Slow it down.
Okay, Chloe Cole. Now, she said she just got off the phone from the Disney annual shareholders meeting. She said, I needed to call out Bob Iger and the rest of the board's hypocrisy and the dangerous lies they feed to us through the media.
Yeah, that doesn't do it. I get it, but like it doesn't change anything.
Well, Joe, let's just watch. Let's watch the video and then you add your piece to it. Y'all let me know if y'all can hear.
She limits the presentation to 2 minutes at most. Your line is open now.
Good morning. I am Chloe Cole, patient advocate for Do No Harm, a group that seeks accountability in the medical profession. I am presenting proposal number 7 titled Report on Gender Transitioning Compensation and Benefits, sponsored by National Legal and Policy Center. Disney pays for gender transition interventions, but not detransitioning care. Therefore, the company discriminates based on gender identity under EEOC regulations. I speak from personal experience as someone who was deceived and physically harmed at a young age by gender ideology, validated by the medical industry and pushed to the masses by corporations like Disney.
I don't know what the freak she's talking about right now. Influenced by
modern media and social networks, I began a transition to male at age 12. By age 16, after practitioners I trusted encouraged me to take puberty blockers and get a double mastectomy, I tried to come back to reality, but it was too late. My body has been irreversibly damaged, and years later, my chest is still in bandages. Damn. My doctors have abandoned me. You doctors look...
Fair use, you too.
As a result, I am suing those professionals who steered me into taking these destructive steps that have permanently scarred me. But Disney, in its arrogance, has responded to our proposal by stating that I am only trying to generate attention for a limited agenda. Mr. Iger, Disney, under your watch, is pushing the limited agenda of gender ideology. Disney has become the Ursula that is stealing the voices of thousands of little Ariels across the world.
Hold on, let me pause real quick. Pause. I thought that's what they wanted, the Rainbow Coalition. Ain't that what they wanted? And look, I'm ignorant right now.
Okay, this person used to be a transgender.
Gotcha.
So she was a female changing into a male. She had her chest. This is close. If you don't know who she is, she's a big act. You know, she has come to the light, put it this way. She had surgery done to remove her chest. She was taking it's crazy story. So, it's a very sad story. And now
I'm not trying to make fun of this. I'm just trying to.
No, I get what you're saying. Just so you know who this person is. So they've come back to who they are. And now, you know,
good for her.
Yeah. And she's trying to fight against, you know, people under the age of 18 or whoever getting surgery and blockers and all that stuff. So she's an advocate. She's an advocate for this. The trans thing is a lie, basically.
Oh, so she blaming Disney for like
What Disney has, Disney in as part of their like they are funding stores. They are in California. They are funding this type of therapy for employees of Disney. So if I was an employee at Disney and I had a child, if I had a girl that's like, I need to be a boy or whatever, I could go to Disney and be like, yeah, my child at 6 years old is the wrong gender and Disney will pay for the change.
Wow, yeah. That's crazy.
So she's fighting the Disney saying, you need to stop this. This is not right. You need to remove this. Stuff like that. So,
dang. Okay, gotcha. Yeah. Anybody want to add in before I hit play again?
Yeah, it's a long story that I kind of summed it up as fast as possible.
Yeah, here in Alberta, they passed a law right now where the premier is getting a lot of heat for that nobody can do anything until they're the legal age of 18 years old.
I don't see nothing wrong with that.
Yeah. So it's
if you want to do it, do it when you're older.
You're going to see it more and more spread across the countries and states and stuff like that as well, where they're going to put these laws in place where they're not going to give any funding whatsoever until you have legal age and your conscious mind and knowing what you do, with the help of psychologists as well to sign off on it before you go ahead and do these things.
Bro, if they this sinister behind the scenes, no wonder these films going to
They're not behind the scenes, though. They're open about it. When you they had a big presentation a year ago about this, saying that if you work for us, we will provide the services. They were never hiding this. This is wide open. Just people don't know about it.
Yeah, I don't know about it. And so, matter of fact, I'm stupid too. Let's continue.
Put it out.
Stop it.
We can be something. Stop it. Never be.
You're not stupid. Just not. You know. You just didn't know about this.
It's only a matter of time before current or past employees whose bodies and lives have been irreversibly harmed will show up at your door looking for justice and restitution. Please vote for proposal number 7.
Man, shout out to Chloe, man. Shout out to Chloe.
See, this is the truth that they don't tell. There's a lot of them out there who are suffering from deep regret.
Massive. You know,
they were not capable of really knowing and realizing what they were doing, you know, when they made this choice that was going to pretty much change their whole lives for the rest of their lives.
Yeah.
And you have a president who wants to acknowledge and shout out a day, you know, Easter, that's going to shout out, you know, trans people and stuff. And I mean, there's like a great evil that's going on here, man. I mean, you got to at least give people their equal say. Like, if, you know, if they're doing this and they're regretting it, they need to have a voice for that. But they're being drowned out by people who are just applauding it all over the place. Like, this is just the thing to do. And they're not telling the other side of the story. Because if people were more informed, they might make a better decision.
And on top of that, they're doing the whole, that's all over X or Twitter, the whole new month for April with the Gayprol now. I'm like, don't you, how many months you need? Days, months, how many you need? Like, but they're sitting there saying, oh, they are the most oppressed, they're being silenced. Like, silenced where? In what dimension are you being silenced?
And it's funny because the people that I know that are, you know, gay and stuff, they're not happy with all this attention that's going on and things like that. They're not, a lot of them are not asking for all this.
Yeah. I know some too that's like that. I know some too. And I know some that's comic book heads and they don't like all the stuff that's going on with the characters. You know, when the characters go on the Skittle Nation, like Lorena said. And speaking of Lorena, Lorena is in the building.
What's up, Lorena?
Hello, everybody. How you doing?
Hola,
hermana. What's up?
Ladies and gentlemen, after this stream right here, make sure to check out Lorena's channel where she gave an excellent interview talking about the Black Girl Gamers controversy that I don't have no clue about, but we're going to be talking about that soon enough. Yeah. But I wanted to finish
I got to say, because you would do this the other way around, having no clue about that is your way of admitting that you don't watch Lorena's videos and you don't watch my video. Because we've been covering this, Fatal. Huh?
Bro, Mark, I watched your video. I watched Lorena's interview, and I still don't know what the freak is going on because I'm just that person. I've been told
we're
you
not
guys
doing
that.
Our job.
At this point, you should know.
Shame on us.
At this point, you should know I'm not faking when I say these things. Okay, I was in those classes. Speaking of riding the short bus, we got Value Renegade right here dropping this important information. Shout out to y'all trying to set me up. He put riding the short bus right there, and you can see it. I'm not saying Value Renegade wrote the short bus. See, you guys always trying to play. Now let's continue. Bob Iger suggests story takes precedence over messaging. 2 hours later, Silver Surfer gets gender swap in another $300 million future Marvel box office bomb. I think he had more. Let me see. Maybe that was it.
I can't wait for this movie to bomb. Like now it's just me pointing and laughing at them now. That's what I'm doing. It's all about pointing and laughing because this don't make any sense. Like you can't, like it boggles my mind that you went from actually the Incredible Hulk, which is the first one, but Iron Man, right? You went from Iron Man all the way to Endgame, You knew the formula that worked. You're like, you know what? Perfect idea. Let's do everything opposite of that and see what happens. That's what they're doing.
Well, that's because they don't care about money. They care about the message. And they have enough institutional investors. These are the people with like, over, I forget how many billions of dollars in stock. They don't care. That is the crux of it. They do not care. They don't care about the little people like me and the people who got their screen questions, you know, in, or the people who put the shareholder proposals on that Disney said don't vote for, that made perfect and total sense. They really do not, because they are beholden to the base. Part of it is the Skittles Nation, all of that, that they're stuck in this now. They are going to have to ride the sucker until the wheels fall off.
You know, and that's the thing that you're saying, they don't care and it's just about the message. But at some point, like, the thing that gets me is that they see they always talk bad about your paying customer. They ignore your paying customer. They do everything we tell you not to do. But the thing that gets me that really is the crux of everything is that you do understand you don't have Star Wars. You don't have Disney. You don't have anything if it's not for us. The people is what pay your salary. We're telling you stop doing stuff. And so, I mean, I get they got all the money, but at some point, money is not infinite. Some point you're gonna run out of it at some point.
It might not be
tomorrow, but at some point you will if you keep doing this.
Oh yeah, but the thing is, it doesn't hurt enough. They're not hurt enough yet. That's the thing. They are not losing enough money to the point where they have to finally listen to the people.
And just next generations that are coming up are stupid, okay? And I hate to say it, but it's the truth. I call them generation dumbass, and it's because it's not their fault, right? It's just that they're being conditioned. I mean, you see what's going on in these public schools, you know? It's like they want the population to be dumbed down so much that they will be that much easier to control all around the planet. So us, you know, we're going to be dying out. It's like they don't really care about us or our money. These people are looking to control the world. That's what Elon is in it for. That's what Zuckerberg, that's what all of these elite people hired in them. That's what they're in this for. So to me, it's just one big mass conditioning. They'll take the loss that they have to take with us, you know, but what they want are the kids. You know, that's why I keep talking about it. It's always about the kids. You know, and you see what the kids are looking like now. Mm-hmm. You know, they got us. We're supposed to be in a country that's got freedom of speech. We'll sit on here talking about he unalived himself. You know what I mean? It's like we're afraid. We're tiptoeing around our own speech, you know? And that's where we're going. If we're this bad, where we can't say how we feel and what we think, you can imagine what the kids are going to be like and subsequent generations. So that's really, to me, from what I'm seeing, that's what it's all about, man.
Well, I get you. That makes sense.
I would drop the mic, but it would break.
But you know what? Right. You know, and that's one of the things I was kind of talking about behind the scenes. Like, you know, YouTube is not really like the moneymaker, but as long as I'm able to utilize this to keep my voice out, you know, that's my message to counter their message. It might not, you know, like you say, Mark, you put your thing as more of an archive for your son going forward. That's what your channel is for, right? So
yeah. That's
the way I feel like with my niece. I don't have any, you know, direct kids of my own, but I have nieces, nephews, and goddaughters and stuff. So for me, this is my message for them going forward, right? So that we, Fed, are you all right over there?
Sorry, man. Fatal just disappeared. I was like,
"Yeah, I'm here, man. I'm eating chicken nuggets and having a good time."
I got all sweaty,
man.
I'm like, "Every time D's supposed to do something, point,
Fatal got to just interrupt." D is
dropping some science, and he playing games, musical, whatever. Go ahead, D.
But yeah, so you know that's what I'm saying. Even if YouTube tomorrow, you know, I'm not making any money off of it or whatever. The point that we are able to put our voice out there to counter their message, it's got to count for something. At least we doing this much. Because, you know, like you said, Mark, we're not going to be here forever, right? But at least, if anything, as long as this internet is for, you know, they say internet's for everyone. They tell the ladies about being modest. As long as my voice is up here forever, at least there'd be some kind of a injection of sanity still out there. That's what I at least hope, that it'd be there.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Hey, are you saying something, Fatal?
No, sir.
No.
Okay.
He just eats mumbles.
Okay.
Oh.
Getting it to eat on.
It okay. It okay to that hour. We at that hour mark. I want everybody to stick around. Smash the like button because something is about to happen. And I'm going to tell you what's about to happen. A commercial break. Stick around, folks.
This poor bastard right here put his whole hand in his mouth. For fun, too, because his friend told him to. Ain't that right, motherfucker? I don't know what the hell these kids are thinking these days. And it was just last week he was in the back of the class trying to suck his own dick. Nasty motherfucker. He was close, too, till he busted in his own damn face. Hell, at this point, I'm just waiting to see what he gonna do next. Go ahead and let me know next time you wanna do some dumb shit, and I'm gonna shove my whole foot up your ass. Oh, now you gonna cry, huh?
Billy Mays here with another fantastic product. Check this shit out. It's called OxyClean, and it's fucking addicting. Look at that. Okay, let's uncharge the vaginal discharge that's in this bowl. It's safe on your colors. It's gonna make your stuff look all brand new. And then we're gonna throw in this free little squirt bottle here that's got some OxyClean inside. Now check this shit out. Apparently, someone took a shit on the carpet, and then the poopetrator decided to cover it all up by spilling some wine. But guess what? It's no match for OxyClean. OxyClean's gonna make that shit look fucking brand new. Down in the basement, you got a little crime scene going on, little blood on the walls? Just put some OxyClean on there, wipe that shit off. The evidence is gone. Alright, now it's time to get rid of some stains, okay? Sometimes when I use OxyClean, I make stains of my own. But that's not the point here. The point is to get rid of the stains, because that's what OxyClean does. That's what you're going to be doing. Don't you want some? I know I do. Alright, here's some regular laundry detergent. It just doesn't cut it. Their shit's weak. It's not doing it. But my shit's very strong. My shit will fuck you up, son. Look at that. Yeah, buddy. Shit's looking brand new right about now. All those clothes, they're going to smell better. They're going to look better. You're going to want it. You're going to want it because I want it. And what do I think about it? It's fucking awesome. Don't you want some? I know you do. What are you doing just sitting there? $40 value? Fuck that shit. My shit's $19.95. Make gallons of this shit. Like I said before, cleaning all kinds of shit with a squirt bottle and free chamois. Also, we'll throw in this bottle of Orange Clean. That's right, the power of an orange in your hand. Did you have fiesta night at your house and everyone got the shits? You don't know what's a fiesta and what's a shit. Doesn't matter. For just $19.95, you get everything you need. First, we're going to start you off with the small stuff for all you cheap bastards out there. But when you're ready to move up to the bigger, better stuff, we're going to give you the big tub, because that's what you want.
Damn. Bro, where you be getting these things from, man?
Why?
Fiesta and shit. Thanks.
I don't understand, bro. Like, what motivates you? Why do you do the things you do, bro? Seriously.
All right, man. Just give it 10 seconds because this is going to be a terrible segue, but I mean this in the best way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Everybody be serious. We lost a legend. We didn't get to talk about this on the last Dark Council show. This guy right here, man, very legendary, man. Let's check it out right here. Los Angeles AP, Louis Gossett Jr., the first black man to win the Best Supporting Actor Oscar, dies at 87. Do anybody have any movies out there that stood out with this guy right here in it? Because I definitely have one.
Enemy Mine.
Officer and a Gentleman.
Mm. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Iron Eagle.
Iron Eagle, baby. Iron Love Eagle. Them Iron Eagle films. Yeah. That's the original Top Gun.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Oof.
He also was what was that movie where he played an alien?
Enemy Mine. I love that movie, bro.
Enemy Mine. Yeah, he was awesome in that movie.
But Enemy Mine was so dope. I'm surprised he never did get a sequel.
Some things don't need a sequel, bro. That was the story now.
Of like two enemies coming together, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Two enemies coming together to crash land
or something like that, and then when that race was asexual, so he had a baby, and then the human took care of his enemy's son, basically. So that's what it was.
But peep this out, though. Think about how dope the moral of the story was. They were trying to teach us. It don't matter what alien race or what race you are. You can always come together because the guy, what's the white guy name? The guy, he famous.
Joe.
His brother is in the Vacation Napoons. You know the wild uncle. What's the wild uncle name?
You're the host. You're supposed to have this pulled up, man.
You're supposed Randy to have Quaid, that.
Randy Quaid.
Quaid. Quaid. Dennis Quaid.
Oh yeah, Quaid. Okay,
Randy.
Quaid.
Randy.
Randy Quaid. Thank you, Lorena, the best producer. Randy Quaid. He was a racist against these aliens, bro.
It was Dennis Quaid.
Oh, it was Dennis.
Randy Quaid was the crazy guy that was in Independence Day.
Now, I threw off because I said
Randy was in the Vacation movie.
Randy was in Vacation, correct.
I threw off. It was my fault.
But top of the line hosting right there.
But let me tell you how original this movie was. Bosco, you ever seen this movie?
A long time ago. I don't even remember it.
Okay, well, the moral of the story, the whole moral was the guy, he was a human being. They were fighting against these aliens. They got stranded on this planet. They had to survive.
Did I just say that, Fatal? Fatal,
what I'm No, but look, I'm trying to break it down, though, to its simplest core. Basically, what they were trying to show was that it don't matter what race you are, because he ended up being a father to his son, or whatever that was he gave birth to, tadpole or whatever. And they don't make dope films like these no more. Somebody laughing at me. I'm trying to be serious right now.
Stripe of Chase cracking me up.
A tadpole?
Ain't he a frog? All lives matter. Bro, he a frog, though. Let's keep it all the way real. He a frog. Anyways, he took care of his son, tadpole or whatever, and he started fighting for the slaves because they were slaves to humans as well. It was a lot of deep meanings behind this film right here, man.
So and they were basically sad part about this film. Original, I'm reading here, the original budget for this movie was $17 million. But because of whatever reason, it skyrocketed over $40 million, and at the time in 1985 was one of the most costly movies to come out. It was a box office failure, earning little over $12 million. However, it was one of the first films to show up in the Soviet Union and had massive success over there. And then it later on became a cult classic.
So it had a cult following.
Man, $12 million, man. That's crazy. Like, now they need movies to make $1 billion just to be successful. It's like, that's wild.
Shout out to my boy, Louis Gossett, in memory of you. And for the people who don't know in the chat, we're going to look at the trailer for Enemy Mine. Here you go.
Marooned on a desolate planet, he is a soldier. Alone with his enemy.
Fair use, you two.
Don't you get the English, huh?
Man,
fair use.
I don't love you, and you
20th
don't love
century
me.
Fox going to get you.
Here, you understand?
I know they're going to hit me up. Hold on, let me pause. Because they got me last time I did this. Fair use, you two. Fair use.
To tolerance.
You saved my life.
What? I need to look at another face, even as ugly as yours.
As Louis Gossett, ladies and gentlemen.
Mm-hmm.
Will lead to friendship.
We should open up a little place here. I could ruin the food. You could scare away the customers.
Fair use, you two. Fair use.
That
works.
Friendship. Will come an overwhelming responsibility.
You must be a parent.
At least you're in the whole movie.
You must take my place.
Protecting a life he values more.
Hold on, so we gonna act like this wasn't a tadpole, though. Y'all want to act like that's a kid? That's his tadpole. All slimy, look like a boo-boo from Fatal J. Let's continue.
Oh, my God.
There we go.
That is over.
I had to go ruin it.
Yeah, they showed a whole movie in this trailer. Dang.
They did. This is the whole movie.
Dennis Quaid, Louis Gossett Jr., Wolfgang Peterson's enemy mine.
That's crazy. That's back when movies required actors to act because there wasn't anything else going on. It's just two people. But can I share with y'all something real quick?
Yes, sir.
Can you share my screen? Look at what the competition was for this film in 1985. Back to the Future, Beverly Hills Cop, Rambo, Rocky, Cocoon, The Goonies, Police Academy, Fletch, A View to a Kill, European Vacation, The Breakfast Club, Pee-wee's Big Adventures,
E.T.
re-release, Spies Like Us, Arnold, Commando, The Killing Fields, Teen Wolf.
Man, that's
look at all.
Man, all these
Jewel of the Nile. Jewel of the Nile.
Be crazy. Damn, of like
The Last Dragon.
Weird Science, Summer Rental, Santa Claus, the movie, Friday the 13th. Look at how different
Black
like
Cauldron.
Every movie is. Good. You got horror, you got sci-fi, you got children, you got look at all the creativity Nightmare the box office used to throw out there. The Gods Must Be Crazy. Enemy Mine is way down here.
Yeah, you can tell there was no Crush Groove.
So, Crush Groove. You know.
It was you know what? Wow. Now I understand why it flopped.
But I'm saying, yeah, classes. look at every, like, these top 10 right here is like these are some of the greatest movies ever made, man. Back to the Future, Beverly Hills Cop, man. You know, Rambo Part 2. Then, like, Rambo, Sylvester Stallone had a Rambo and a Rocky,
yeah.
3 and 4. Witness, that was an amazing film if you've never seen that, with Harrison Ford. The Goonies, of course, that's one of my personal favorites. Fletch is Chevy Chase. View to a Kill is a James Bond film. So you got James Bond, two comedies, all family adventure, a suspenseful, this is a murder mystery. If you never saw Witness, it's an excellent film. Cocoon had like senior citizens. Yeah, if y'all ever see Cocoon?
Yeah,
senior citizens like start to go like get young again because of Aliens. Yeah. So I guess that would consider sci-fi. You got action adventure comedy, I guess you'd say, for Eddie Murphy.
And then you got Mask, that's drama as well, with what's her name? Cher. Mask with Cher.
I mean, look at this. So you've got an African-American lead, which is the number two movie, you know? Crazy. It's just crazy. We have really dropped the ball when it comes to
Hollywood
films nowadays,
right?
Like from 1985.
Now.
Holy crap. The average budget for these films is $65. What the? $65 or less? $65 million, excuse me.
$65 million. Like, I'm about to say.
Yeah, streaming has saturated a lot of the movies.
Now, when you couple that with what was going on in music at that time, the 80s were no joke, bro.
Oh.
Like, we were, like, just tops with everything. We were peak entertainment. Movies, you know, music, TV shows.
Yeah.
I love the 80s. I mean, that's what the show was called, and I agree. The 80s were great.
Hip-hop was coming in strong. Mm-hmm. We were getting the Beat Street. We got, like, Crush Groove. You saw it.
Yeah, Crush
Groove. Which was better, though? Which was better, the 80s or the 90s?
80s. I'm looking at the 80s now. You had Billy Ocean, New Edition, Bryan Adams, Whitney Houston, Stevie Wonder, Kool and the Gang, Huey Lewis in the News, Paul Young, Madonna,
come on,
Tears for Fears, Wham. Holy crap. Yeah. Wham. Duran Duran, Aretha Franklin. All these were the top 10. All these had a top 10.
You know,
had
Prince
a top 10
is in there. Michael.
Tina Turner, Michael Jackson, Prince. All in that. Yeah. That's crazy.
The 90s were good too, but the 80s were better. 80s.
Lionel Richie, look at that.
The 80s was cold because I just got finished watching a Transformer movie and a G.I. Joe movie. Man, those were some dope cartoons, man. Cartoon film.
You know what the number one song in 1985?
What was it?
Was from Wham.
Wake me up.
Yeah, I'm about to say.
Careless
Never
Whisper.
Gonna dance again.
Never gonna dance again.
Yeah.
Guilty, that's a good song, bro.
No, that's wild.
Yeah. Mr. Head, thank you so much. Y'all check out Mr. Hat channel. Got over 100K subscribers. He makes dope, super dope YouTube shorts. And I think he has a book called Fiddle.
Mr. Hat is my Haitian brother, man. I talk to him all the time. We talk about Haiti and things that are going on in Haiti right now. So, Mr. Hat.
He's cool, man. Mr. Hat, he said, times are crazy. Sometimes I'm ashamed of being Gen Z, laugh out loud. Thoughts on the new Deadpool movie. I feel like it'll be mid. Now, we already talked about the Deadpool movie. Drunk said he felt like it's not going to hit a billion and it's not going to move the needle. I got a question, though. What are we, Gen Z or Gen Z younger than us? Which is Gen Z? Are we Generation X?
Gen
Z? Like,
I'm Gen X.
Yeah,
I'm Gen X.
Okay, yeah, how do you know that?
You're a millennial.
You're a millennial.
I'm supposed to be 38, so what am I?
You're a millennial. You're the same age as my brother.
Gen Z, basically born from the year 2000 to 2015. So,
2015. Oh, he a baby. Dude,
they should be between the ages of 12 and 29.
All right, I'm not going to talk. I'm just going to play this. We're going to speak on it, and we're going to move on.
It's loading. Here we go.
Fair use of Disney Plus.
Oh, my God.
You didn't know to say Disney or Fox.
What am I looking at?
Man, just keep watching.
Okay.
You know you my dude, man.
Just keep watching. Dang.
You know he my dude.
Just keep watching.
That was from an episode of X-Men 97.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And that was the new episode. Have anybody been watching all the episodes? I've watched them all.
So I've been watching anime because that's far superior than anything else you're going to watch.
Disney Plus.
I agree.
Neither do I.
Nobody, but I haven't watched it yet.
So I'm the only person that watched X-Men 97.
Yes.
Bosco, you watched
I got you, man. I watched it.
What are your thoughts, Bosco?
Of this episode, I think it's the weakest out of the four.
I agree, it is weak. It's definitely filler. But do you think about the episodes before that, though?
Oh, they're on point. The nostalgia is there. They're, you know, DeMaio, I know he got fired for maybe they're saying that OnlyFans things, but his writing on this series right now is on point. So I'm wondering what they're going to do. I know he wrote both seasons, and I know it got renewed for a third season right now. So I don't know. So far, people are liking it. The people I speak to are really enjoying it. I know people are complaining about, you know, they're compressing a lot of, like, you know, the Inferno storyline that, you know, with Madeline Pryor, you know, that it should be extended more because there's so much to tell. But
yeah,
so far, I like how they're doing it. I like their formula, how he's presenting these stories and how he's telling them throughout the characters. So I'm enjoying it right now.
I'm enjoying it. Like you said, I have the Phoenix and Madeline Pryor. I have those runs, those trade paperbacks, and that's definitely a long run because they actually knew Madeline Pryor and Jean was two different people. But I think it's still dope how the guy wrote this. Now, Bosco, I'm going to ask you this question, and then we're going to carry on. Do you think the writer got in trouble for his OnlyFans, or you think it was something deeper than that?
Well, they dropped him faster than they dropped Jonathan Majors.
Yes.
So I don't know. It must have been something serious in order to drop him. And he completely, I think he went dark. His whole Instagram disappeared. Everything that he was promoting for the show disappeared. So yeah. it's weird. I don't know. I know some of you have more connections in the industry than I do up here in Montreal, but it was really a shock how quick it was.
Yeah, man, it's sad because the only writer at Marvel right now that's putting out dope content, we won't see him. You know what I mean? We won't get none of his work anymore. So it sucks. D, you got something for us? I see something.
I wanted to show you something real fast. So this is what I'm watching right now. So you want to talk about a fantastic, this right here is great. The premise of this is
what up, Ziva Fit.
The main character, which is Frerin, she is an elf. And obviously all her mates or her teammates are humans. Mm-hmm. And for her, things just goes by fast. Like, you know, time is different for her. So for her, a couple of years go by, all her friends are dying. So it's telling the story of how she, you know, how she goes back and kind of chases the steps of her friends or see them as they were young, but and she stayed young. And then by the time she goes to see them, they're old men, they die and all stuff like that. So it's a very powerful story. And she takes on one of her friends, basically stepdaughter, which is the girl you see the purple hair, and she goes and make her an apprentice. And I'm only like on fourth episode, so I haven't seen the whole thing, obviously. It has like 29 episodes, I believe. But this is what I'm watching right now. If you want to have something good to watch, right there.
I'm gonna ask y'all a question. Did anybody just hear anything D just said? That's what I thought. Let's go to the next one.
You felt it, though. You can tell you felt it. You're passionate about it. Yeah. Let's do that.
Let's go to the next one.
Where are you watching it?
Crunchyroll?
Netflix. Yeah, I'm playing with you, man.
Oh, where I'm watching
it? Yeah,
Crunchyroll.
Yeah. Crunchyroll. Yeah. D, I'm playing with you, man. I got to get you, man. All right, ladies and gentlemen. This is the point of the night where it's going to get real.
Oh, no.
Cool. It's going to get real messed up. Because Netflix just dropped a trailer out there. This is going to be the reboot of Good Times. Now, black, white, Hispanic, Asian, whoever, we could all agree that Good Times was some dope TV series, cinema, whatever you want to call it. So keep Good Times, the real Good Times in your head. And this is the Good Times reboot. Kat, please prepare yourself for some real demoralization. Let's go.
I have important news.
Let me guess. The state called and they want to cut you a disability check for your face.
Hold up. You can get paid for that?
This is from a fool who stares at his orange juice every morning.
It says concentrate on the box. Who the dummy now?
Shit. Me for not wearing a condom.
Shadows fall over my heart.
It all started with my grandfather, James Evans. My job as the man of this house is to take care of this family no matter what.
I just want to let you know I'm going to take good care of Gray.
Gray, who is this I'm about to kill?
Juan, my boyfriend. Daddy, let him go.
Maybe you should come with me.
Junior's repeating the 10th grade for the third time.
Is there anything you can suggest to help him get to the drive-thru?
Can you do OnlyFans? Take off your shoes. Let me see what kind of feet you're working with.
To the dark side.
Dear Black Heavenly Father,
College Redeemer,
if you could just help us.
Son, it's for you.
New phone, who this?
All black, everything.
At least they ain't got that drug dealing baby under my roof no more.
Man, my mouth ready for some milk right now.
Dalvin, why are you so breast obsessed?
It's childish, man.
Bruh, I'm a baby. I can't get no more childish than that.
In a nocturnal state of mind.
Your neighborhood is a real shithole.
It's the system. They put the guns and drugs on the streets.
Underneath this black, black sky.
This is getting dangerous. I won't just sit back and let you put yourself in harm's way. I love you too damn much.
Everything black.
The revolution will not be televised.
Come on, Rosa Parks, can't you just enjoy this?
Black bird, black sky.
We're just as good as the Evans of old.
Isn't that just dynamite?
But the truth is, we're the Evans of new.
Bitch, you look like money.
Everything black.
What about the struggle?
We're black. It'll be here tomorrow.
Everything black. Black bird, black woman, black.
minute. The baby, little baby, and baby baby.
Too many babies around this crib.
Straight bush. It's so bad.
Ooh. Oh my
God. It's so bad. I'm laughing. It's so bad. I laugh at that. You know what I mean? So who wants to
I hate everything about that. Everything about it.
I wish I could laugh, but no, I can't. I just get angry when I look at it because the good times that I remember, that show was about a Black family trying to stay on the right path regardless of all the mess that was going around them in the projects. You had a strong Black father, you had a strong mother, you had a strong family unit, and they were trying to keep that together despite everything that was going on in the projects. And this is one of the most bigoted pieces of entertainment that I have ever seen. And Seth MacFarlane is attached to this nonsense.
Is this supposed to be a remake
of
live action? From the show from the 70s?
Yeah. You seen Good Times, right? Let's go.
Sorry?
You seen Good Times, right?
I watched. If you're talking about the live action back in with Amos, the guy from
James Amos, yeah.
I've maybe watched a couple of episodes on reruns, but is this supposed to be like a remake of that series?
It's supposed to be a continuation of that.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. And this is going on.
It's the family, like it's the kids.
Yeah,
it's the kids of the kids.
So the kids didn't grow up and like do anything right, different.
You got to keep in mind the characters in the original show. All of them were gifted. There was no way that they were going to stay in the projects for another
That's
two
what I'm
generations.
Saying.
As a matter of fact, by the end of the show, they were getting out of the projects. So why they would still be there after about 40, 50 years in the very same apartment is just unforgivable to those characters.
Yeah, they sure did.
There's just no way. You know, the guy, the father here, is saying that his grandfather was James Evans. Now, I don't know if they mean the John Amos character or they mean the Jimmy Walker character, because he was Junior. He was James Junior. So
that's right.
He would have to be one of their sons, either J.J., Thelma, or Michael.
Who said Dynamite? That's James?
That was J.J. He said J.J. Dynamite.
Yeah.
And the person they had saying Dynamite in the cartoon wasn't even the family, but that was the teacher. That was Wanda Sykes saying it.
So they were really mocking
when
they did that. Mm-hmm. You know, it's...
So,
oh my God,
that I've talked about this, Mark. I've seen your video on this, and I've talked about it too. This is insulting, is what it really is. Because you know, it's one thing. Like I know people in projects, like my mom's in the project stuff. Like it's nothing wrong being in projects, but the thing is this what they're doing is not just about being in a project. It's about pushing a narrative that needs to stop, because we like. I said this in my video, says we have to search. We have to look and find good stories about, like, and it sucks not to bring up the one story that we talked about a couple of weeks ago with the young man who made the cure for cancer with the soap, right? The stuff. You got to search for stuff like that. It's like a needle in a haystack. But you pop on anything, any social media, you know, like Mark, you say this, we understand that they have the whole push against the white guy and everything going on. But think about it. The stuff that against the Black men has never stopped. It has never stopped, because you flip on anything on Twitter or X or the news, whatever, what do you see? And you see the nonsense, right? And to me, it's like, you know, at my age, I can consider myself the elder. I'm like, you're not, to me, when I look at that, even as a youngster, when I did my little roam in the streets, I never did anything that would bring reproach on my parents. It's like these kids do stuff and they put it on camera to bring reproach on their parents. And obviously we could just talk about stuff like that. But that's the type of stuff that this thing promotes. That kind of stuff. A baby drug dealer? Like, come on, bro. Like, you can't. Like, I know people say, oh, you got the Boondocks. But the Boondocks was satirical in their comedy when they said it. And they weren't disrespectful when they did it, at least to me. And when they did stuff, it wasn't about drugs. Like when Riley was dealing, it was candy. Like it could have been used as a analogy for the drug thing, but it was candy, right? When Riley was doing his dealing. But this is like, he's literally selling drugs.
Come but on, they, bro. Like, really? The thing about Boondocks, though, it was making fun of the
black throat. That's what I'm saying. It's done satirically. That's what I'm saying. It can be done properly.
Yeah.
This is not that. This is not that.
With the Boondocks, you had the commentary, especially the one they did about BET.
Yes. Yes.
Where Huey just watched BET, and the more he watched, the lazier he got. And that was a whole commentary on that whole thing, just why programs like that just suck all of the logic out of your, you know, out of your brain. And they made some serious commentary, you know, throughout that, wrapped up in the humor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What's up, Abu Nas?
Most definitely, Lorena. In honor of Abu Nas being grateful and sending out a super chat, Abu Nas, I want you to meet the marginalized cousin. One more time. I'm just kidding.
Good Times wasn't in New York, right? It was in Chicago.
Chicago.
So, and they actually the building that they were in, was that like portrayed in an actual city, or was it like a made up city?
Metropolis.
Like, did they just make up? Did they use an actual city that they were in, or did they? I mean, they said Chicago, correct? Like,
I always wanted
it was set in Chicago.
I remember Chicago.
That was it. Okay. So, like, you know, like New Jack City, the Carter Apartments is actually like a.
That's real.
You can go visit those apartment complex, correct?
Yeah.
Was they really selling crack out of there though?
I don't think so.
I don't think so. Not like that.
But I know, like, when they filmed it, like they when the movie was done, I think people were visiting those. Like, just to get like a selfie or something in front of, and they're not called the Carter, but so I just wondering, well,
Joe, we ought to go one time and you feel me, and I'll be like, this, he keep calling me. shout out to Abu Nas, he said, salute.
Now I gotta know, is that in New York? Are those Carter Apartments in New York?
The Carter Apartments?
I gotta look that up now.
I know Lafayette. I know Marcy Projects.
Look it up. Look it up. Salute to the amazing Dark Council. I seriously miss my family, but I have to stay fasting. Just came in to see the buffoonery trailer. Shaking my head, putting our people back 50 years behind this madness. Love you.
Yeah.
Love y'all. We got Super Sly 75 with the $3. Thank you so much, sir. He says, sorry, Good Times was the worst TV show ever. Dang, bro, really?
I respectfully disagree. I've heard the arguments against the original Good Times. I think people were focusing way too much on the wrong elements of that. I mean, if you were looking at, if you were focusing on JJ and thinking that he was a buffoon, if that's what it is, I mean, you're saying this, but you can't really expand on it. So I don't want to make assumptions here. But see, in the later episodes, in the later seasons, even JJ stood up for his family. You know, he took more of a protector role. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, there was the aspect where he was, you know, being a buffoon, so to speak.
Hustler.
But the character did progress. The character did progress and the character did grow. And I don't think it was nearly as bad. Just my opinion. I don't think it was nearly as bad as people try to act like it was, especially when James Evans was a part of the show, the father.
Yeah.
You know, I think you got to consider the time in the 70s. It was speaking to a very specific time, which is why this doesn't sell now. You know what I mean? Like if you were in the projects back in the 70s, like my father came from the projects, Demajan, you just said Marcy Projects. He was born and raised in Marcy Projects. Got out of the projects, only took him, it didn't take him four generations to do it. You know what I mean? Like, you know, he struggled, he sacrificed him and my mom, and, you know, he gave us a better life. So to have it this way really hurts me to see that they would, after four generations, after, you know, still be there in the very same apartment. It doesn't ring true at all, you know, considering all the talent that was in that family. You know, they did this on purpose to keep them there. And this is what I was talking about. Like when you saw me going at Director X, I mean, that was always the question. Why are we always so at home and comfortable in the projects, in the hood? Like we can never progress out of that. Hollywood wants to keep us there no matter what. And that was one of the taglines of the show. The more things change, the more they stay the same. If you're going to show the Evans family now, why wouldn't you show them like where what they made of their lives? This is telling you they made nothing of their lives. And that's the
slap in the face. You know, if you backed it up a little bit, sorry about that. But if you backed it up, did you, in the shadow of the mom, was she getting like spanked? Like what are we seeing? Like what is this?
And what the dog watching.
Dog's watching it.
Yeah.
That's crazy, you know, instead of giving us stuff like, you know, I know it's like people don't like, you know, looking at this at, you know, fondly because of the things that went down. But again, I bring this up all the time. The Cosby Show, A Different World, Living Single, and I'll even give an honorable mention Blackish in their first few seasons. You don't see Family Matters. You don't see stuff like this where you have more of a wholesome, you know, a black entertainment that we get. And now it's this stuff. You know what I'm saying? 227 or stuff like that. You know, it's
227. Yeah,
like that stuff gone. Like, not, it's, we can't get anything. Everything has to be like Robin Hood or now the Good Times or stuff like that in the projects doing this. And the music, that's not even going to the music. We were talking about music earlier, but the music is just terrible.
Well, I can give you one. I can give you one better with respect to the 70s, the Jeffersons.
Moving on up.
That was my show. I said, you got this black man. He's rich, lives, you know, in the high rise apartment.
I know that song. In the sky.
All of that. Fish don't fry in the kitchen. I had to ask my mom what that meant. But this guy. He was on, I guess he was on All in the Family, got into a car accident.
Lorena talking.
Took the money, spun that into seven dry cleaners. And what does he do? The people who lived in the apartment and the projects that he grew up in with his mom and his brother, he was sending money there every month. Weezy thought that she was cheating on him. Because she's like, I don't know where this money is coming. Keep sending it to this address. And he goes to the address and there's a single mom there with her son. And she's like, I don't know where this money came from. It just started showing up and I just decided to save it. So Weezy goes back and he asks George, you know, how come you didn't tell me about it? He said, I thought that you wouldn't, you know, that you'd think it was stupid. But I made myself a promise that when I got out of there and I made enough money, I was going to make life better for whatever family moved in that building.
Wow. Mm.
And I was blew my mind.
A lot of those old shows, they did that though. They had a lot of heart and they did tackle things. Like remember young Janet Jackson, Penny, remember her storyline was the story of child abuse.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know, JJ was trying to run away with a drug addict and he knew he was going to be happy. He was so happy. And she ended up leaving him because she couldn't beat the drugs. It's like I said, back then, these were the issues that they were speaking to. And of course, the title Good Times was kind of like a irony play on, like, you know what I mean? Like they're struggling, but they still have these good times because they're a family that does look out for each other. They do care for each other. And, you know, it kind of gets lost because those characters, they remind so many people of people that we know. You know, James Evans is my father. You know, right from the flared out nose. That's my father. You know what I mean? He got that same look, like I'm gonna tear that ass up. You know, but at the same time, you knew that he was there too. I wish I had a picture of him. I would show you. I am not kidding. That's my father. You know, but this is reminding me of what other people think we are.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
Like, I don't know anybody here. You know, these are some clown asses, and something tells me that they think they're going to start slipping little messages in there you know, to try to make it seem like it's positive or whatever. But you don't sell something like this. You don't sell it with stereotypes, you know, for the whole world to see this. Most people are not even going to watch this show, but they damn sure saw that trailer. So whatever message you think you're going to put in there, whatever positivity, you muted that with this crap that you put out in your trailer.
I mean, they tried to, even in the trailer, they tried to give a commentary on what we know is true, that, you know, the hood always gets the drugs, the guns, and all that stuff. It's, they put that in there, which is commendable, yeah, but look what you're attaching it to, right? Because that is a truth that the system does keep the hood the way it is. And the problem is, this show is keeping the hood the way it is. It's literally, that's what it's doing. It's like a complete circle.
But you gotta, but now the conversation has gone past that. Like, those are the arguments. I heard those arguments back in the 80s, you know, in the 90s. We don't make no guns, man. They put the gun. All right. The conversation has gone past there. The conversation is now about accountability, self-accountability. All right. You could put a gun in front of me right now. I'm not going to shoot anybody with it. You know what I mean? It's like, we know better. And when you know better, you do better. So I don't care who's putting what where. You know, but if you can put it in a cartoon, then I'm pretty sure that means most people know this already. You know what I mean? So I don't accept that excuse anymore. It's like, there's got to be a reason why we don't love each other the way that we should. You know, why we're not taught to love each other the way we should inside of our own homes. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm tired of hearing about the man. You know, I'm tired of that. We won't get anywhere with that stuff. You got to somehow find it in yourself, you know, to do better. All this is doing is handing people excuses.
You're exactly right, bro. And I tell people this every day, and people laugh in my face when I tell them. Michael Jackson solved it with one song. He said, "I'm looking at the man in the mirror. I'm trying to get him to change his ways. It ain't about the man. It's about you and how you gonna move differently from the mistakes or the bad in the past." You know, so I definitely feel that, Mark. And also, something Lorena said that kind of blew my mind when I was a little kid. She mentioned Weezy from what's that show again, when they said Moving On Up?
Jefferson.
Okay, this is what blew my mind about Weezy.
I love you, George.
Why does she sound like that, though?
George, I love you.
She was, I guess, a character. She smoked a lot, huh?
Yeah.
You know, I always blew. So the true story, they really didn't like each other in real life, though.
I need to talk to my New York people real quick. So the Carter Apartments that were in New Jack City are actually called the Graham Court Apartment Complex in Harlem. It is now one of the most luxurious apartment complexes in Harlem, with an average price for $4,000 to $6,000 a month for a two-one bedroom in Harlem.
Harlem world.
Yeah.
But as Harlem, but like, is it like a luxurious place to live now? Like, is that?
It's gentrified,
gentrification.
When you think Harlem, you think Malcolm X Boulevard, all that stuff. It's like,
this is the kind of thing that I usually say for my videos, because I know some people get pissed off by shit like this. But see, Black people live there historically, you know what I mean? And we complain about the hood. Gentrification came in. You know, the white people came in, they put in the Starbucks, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, they wanted access to the city, you know, and everything. That's prime real estate right there. You know, so they came in, did what they had to do, put the people they needed to have put in office, whatever the case may be, and the area got beautiful. You know what I mean? It's like, what's going on? The same thing with Brooklyn. You know, we were in Brooklyn for so long. Yeah, Crooklyn. You know, we killing each other. Yo, murder capital of the world. Gentrification comes in. Now it's a beautiful place to live. It's a shame. You know what I mean?
If we don't value each other,
then what the fuck are we going to get out of any of this? What are we going to get out of life? Nothing. Always looking at the man. If you knew how to spend money in your own community, if you knew how to invest in your children and tell them what they can do, like what I was talking about in my videos. You have to tell them, yes, Fatal J, you can make comics. You can be geeks. You can be this. But historically, all we ever tell each other is what we can't do. Yeah. So we don't do anything. But other people can come in and they do something. So there it is. Like, that's the reason why Harlem looks the way it does now, you know, versus what it looked like before in areas of Brooklyn, too.
Harlem world.
You got, when I get up there, y'all got to take me on a tour because, you know, I'm not from New York. So all I know is from the movies, right? So I didn't know, like, I just want to go to Carter Park, like the basketball.
Like that, though.
Rutgers. Is that what it's called? Rutgers, right? I want to go there and watch basketball.
You remember that movie, like, Fresh?
Huh?
Fresh, yeah. The little boy. The little boy.
Yeah, I want to go. I want to go to the basketball mecca, man. Like, that park is where everybody played. I want to see that. Just take a picture of it. So, like, all the only thing that got me crazy about that is, like, if you have $6,000 a month, you come down to Florida, you staying in, like, a 6'4", like, a swimming pool. Like, you staying in a big house. I just I wasn't looking at it as a color thing. It was like more like, what the heck? $6,000 for a 2-1?
That's cheap. If you go to Long Island City, it's about 7,000.
That's wild.
Right across, that's right across the river. Right across the river. Long Island City.
Man, you gotta take me. Can you guys take me to Rutgers?
Sure, why not? Yeah, when we go up, when we come up there, Fatal J, when we going up there, Fatal J, Fatal J,
is it far?
When we going up there, Fatal J,
bro, is it far from Manhattan? Is it far from Manhattan?
No.
So we can just take an Uber and just drop us off, like.
You said Uber. We're taking a train, bro.
But you got to be respectable on Rucker, right? You can't just be.
Oh, I'm not. I'm not gonna be stupid. I just want to see it. Like, I just want to walk. Like, Dr. J played there, man, in Convert. Like, it just, like, there is a, if you like basketball, there is a history there that is unlike any other. And I just want to, like, just walk over there. Like, it's pretty awesome.
But what I'm saying is, it was guys so cold in Rutgers, they was beating NBA players, right? New York fellas?
Yeah.
Like Earl, the goat, Nana
Dude,
goat.
Dude, there's a picture, and I'm so sorry to get off topic, but I love, like, history and stuff like that. So, like, there's a picture of Dr. J at the park, and people wanted to watch him play that. You look at the way they angled the picture on the rooftops of the buildings all around, they were watching him play basketball. That's
Dr. J?
Yeah, dude. That's incredible, man.
Yeah, Dr. J.
That's a picture I would have framed. That's incredible. So
Dr. J was cold, man. He was incredible. Yeah, last 2 minutes
great,
of the
great
show.
Adventure a long time ago. Yeah, but just to wrap that thing up, bro. Just real quick, the whole thing with the good time stuff. Like what we're talking about here, you know, as far as gentrification, it's like there's a concentrated effort to, like, keep that black image and black vision in one place. You know, they always got to keep bringing it back to this. You know what I mean? This is a family because they deliberately named it Good Times. This is a family that should have been moved past this. You know, but they deliberately brought it back so they can make some other points about what's going on socially and stuff like that. But it doesn't serve the actual character or the story or the vision of the original show. You know what I mean? So, you know, one of the things I want to do tomorrow, one of the videos I'm doing is called what the black community gets their last Jedi moment. You know what I mean? Because the same way we felt in this fandom about how they messed up the vision of George Lucas and all that stuff, that's what they did with the vision of Mike Evans, who created Good Times. Norman Lear was involved too, but it was Mike Evans that created it, you know, and these characters the way they should have been. So now, overwhelmingly, everybody hates this, who's seen the trailer, and they feel betrayed. Now you understand. Now you have a whole other population of people who understand the points that we were making, you know, about what happened with Star Wars. Because this is what Hollywood does. You know, it betrays their audience and then insults them, because now you have the creators behind this show. Now they're beginning to have their say. Yvette Nicole Brown, you know, she's lashing out at the fans. So it's the same thing over and over again. So you see where we're going with this in showbiz. You know, they just want to shit on the fans.
I just wanted to say something, you know? Just to jump on, piggybacking what you're saying. The reason I brought that movie Fresh is that was filmed right up the block from me, where he eliminated that the dog, the pit bull was in that, it was that building he was in. That was actually, that building was one of the first buildings that got gentrified. That's why I brought that up.
That scene messed me up when he hung that pit bull. It was that building
he was in. That was right at the block for me, and that was the first building they got redone. Like they renovated it, and they just made it like an apartment complex now. They did that a lot on my old block, and my block was kind of like, it was kind of okay because literally right across from there, that place where they filmed that is the college. So it was relatively a nicer area to begin with, just because the college was there. But now it's when you look at just my block alone, it's totally different as far as gentrification goes. But yeah, I just wanted to bring that up. But yeah,
between YouTube and Twitter, we got 105 people watching. We missed the end of the show though. Jump 3PO. Let me get Bosco first. Bosco been quiet for way too long. Bosco, this is the new pictures from Daredevil Born Again. Okay.
Oh, they got him back. Nice.
Yep. He back. Both of them back. Bosco, what is your thoughts about this, brother?
I just hope they don't fuck it up.
They are.
That's what I'm saying. Netflix had a great thing going on. If they can give us that caliber of story and character building that they did in that show, and they can be as real, I'm trying to have hope. I know you're shaking your head, but I'm trying to have hope.
They're not gonna do it.
But you know, wishful thinking, say what it is. That's what I hope for, because Bosco, I love these two characters.
Bosco, if you was a betting man, if you had to put it all on this show, either being good or bad, and you make a million or lose your house,
what is this show? You killed me, man.
I'm putting you on the spot. If you had to make a million or lose your house, what is this show going to do?
It's a movie, right?
No, this is a series.
It's a series. Okay. I think it's gonna fall short, to be honest with you. That's what my gut tells me, but my heart tells me I hope it's successful.
The only way it won't fall short, I think, and if they go the rated R route with like Netflix drunk. I know Punisher is your favorite dude. What is your thoughts about this?
They destroyed him in the comic books. In the recent article about the Punisher coming to Daredevil, it was stated that the Punisher is going to have a real problem with police officers wearing the skull on their uniforms. And I'm like, come on, man. This is the whole reason why Marvel got rid of the Punisher in the first place, because they didn't like military or police officers wearing the skull logo. So they were just like, we've got to kill that character. So I think if they try to pull like political stuff in it like that, it's dead in the water, man. It's like, just give us the character from the comic book, man. It's just like, that's all we want to watch. We don't want any messaging. So
they're going to do that drunk. You know that. And I know that's your favorite character.
I don't know if it's confirmed, Sean. It was just written in the article. They've been very hush hush about that. So do we know if that's why Marvel changed it? Yeah. In the comic books? Yes, that's confirmed. Yeah. The creators and stuff have come out, and that's why they did an entire series. And I did a video on it, and it's disgusting. That's why they brought back the Punisher's wife. And in the final episode, he got the wife divorces him, takes his money, sends him through a time portal where he is taking care of orphan children with a different logo and everything. And they're like, who are you? Are you the Punisher? Yes. He goes, no, I'm not the Punisher. I'm Frank Castle. That was the last thing he said. Stupidest thing ever. That's the only video I did on the Punisher comic book series. It was disgraceful. I was like, they just trying to change their image over there in the comic books. Now, will that bleed over to the show? Who knows?
Probably.
So,
here's the thing though. John Bernthal is incredibly based. You know, he has a podcast on YouTube, or at least he used to. I don't know if he still does. But actually, Jay, I could see you interviewing him. Like, he would be a great one for you, you know, your podcast. Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to meet him I think I'm meeting him next month at one of these Comic-Cons. So I'm going to do my little thing.
Get him, bro.
Yeah.
Get him. because if they do that with this show, it would really tell me something about Hollywood and what they do to people, because he's not the type to,
yeah,
like he didn't even want to come back if it wasn't done the right way. You know, he feels very strongly about that. So I'm hoping that says something, you know, for this, you know, but I don't know. Yeah. These days, man, it's hard to have hope.
Now, I think it's like, Jay, you coming to Montreal Comic Con? I will be at the, that was in the private chat. Sorry, boss. There's a Canadian Comic Con that's coming up at the end of the month in, I don't know what it's called. What city that is? It's not Toronto. I just did Vancouver. So, Alberta. I think it's Alberta. So I'll be there, and then I'll be in Toronto as well. So
that's dope.
Yeah.
Man, you're gonna be in a dream. Right?
What's that?
The Philly one's coming up too.
I'll be in Philly. Yeah.
Man, yeah. You live in a dream
for that. So hopefully, I can get it approved.
It's not. I mean, it's cool, but it's a lot of work.
Yeah, but just going to cons would be fun, man.
I know, but I don't get a chance to really walk around much because I'm the security ticket counter, everything for Gina. So it's like, and her lines are massive, dude. Like no matter where we go, yeah. It's like I hope like no one shows up. You know, all those people that protest Gina Carano, I'm like, well, good. Maybe no one will show up, so I don't have to like work all day. It's like, nah. That's just a goof. They're all there to see her. So it's like they're massive. We were in Vancouver and I was like, they had a protest. Well, that if you call that a protest, that three people.
Five people.
And I was like,
no, it was three. It was three. The two people.
Wow.
Were they were like, it's gonna be a smaller con, so you won't be. I was like, okay. And you know, people were saying, yeah, sometimes we get maybe 100, 200 people. I mean, her line just didn't stop. I'm like, it's just constantly people saying win, you know, like win, like we want you to, we're here, we want you to win. So it speaks volume to this whole nonsense, like everything that we talk about with Hollywood and all that stuff, that there is a pulse of people out there that know what's up, and they're willing to pay $100 to walk up to her and just say, we need you to win. Like,
yeah.
So it's pretty impressive.
Junk, I want to ask a stupid question before we end the show. The situation with Lucasfilm, does that hurt her chances of like showing up in a Deadpool movie?
I'm not allowed to talk about the lawsuit at all.
I ain't speaking on it.
She won't be in the Deadpool movie, so don't worry.
Oh, okay. On a closing note, ladies and gentlemen, we halfway there. So I'm hoping by 12 tomorrow.
This ain't Ninja Blast 2. This is the first one.
Yeah, this is the second chance, like you did with
Yeah. Okay, I was about like to say. I already have that one.
Yeah, this is the second chance with new covers. We halfway there, ladies and gentlemen. I'm hoping and praying by tomorrow at 12, we're fully funded. So please go into the description, click that link, and hook your boy up. Because look, at the end of the day, this book is finally, I mean, it's done. It's completely done. I'm trying to pull a Drunk 3PO. I'm trying to pull an Air July. I want to have my books done so I can ship to you quickly. You know what I mean? That's the way. I'm like that dude
that's the right way to do it.
I know we're about to close the show, but can I just show this real quick? Just as I talked on it, I was like, I just wanted people to see. That's the Dr. J photo I was talking about. It was like people on top of the building.
Wow.
Just came to see him play basketball in that park. So anyway, I just wanted to
shout out to Dr. J.
I love it. I just want to stand there, man.
Shout out to rest in peace to Ed Piscor. That really messed me up, man. Condolences to his family. Condolences to the family of Louis Gossett Jr. Did we lose anybody?
Go on, Damacho.
I was going to say, the lovely Sherry, her father passed away too.
Sorry to hear that. Condolences to you.
I just wanted to say about the Ed thing. Listen, it's so important that we have to understand how important it is to treat each other better. You know what I mean? Like to keep that in mind, we have to learn from things like this. It's so easy to be mean to each other online. You know, you get on a keyboard and you just say whatever. But we got to remember, man, people go through things that we couldn't possibly understand. You don't know where anybody's line is, you know, where the edge is at. Yeah. So we have to be more responsible for each other and with each other. And, you know, it's so tragic what happened in that case. Mm-hmm. But what good is it if we don't learn from it? You know, so we got to keep that in mind, man. We can't lose this.
Thank you so much for coming to the show, everybody. Continue smashing like. The timestamps will be up on the playback. Shout out to the playback crew, the replay crew. My guest, our guest on the show, Bosco. Man, we really appreciate you coming to the show.
Yeah, man. Thank you.
Thank you for having me, man. Honestly, you know I'm in everybody's chats, and I've met all through. I've already streamed with Lorena once. Fatal, I think I streamed with you on Rob's channel once. And Mark, I think we did a segment on Chaos Central at one point. You know what? First of all, I have to say congratulations to all of you, man. I've seen your channels grow tremendously, your influence grow even further. And thank you for having a little channel like me on your with you guys, man. And that's the way, right? We network, we help each other out. And Mark, what you said, yes, is dead on, right? You know, father figures are important in today's world more than ever. And I like what you're doing in your channel too, and preaching that to all of us. You know, it's not only about our color and stuff like that. For you guys that live a certain reality, I understand that, but fathers are important as well as mothers, and that's what we need to see in today's movies, is more of a, you know, back to the basics of the nuclear family, and that's how we're going to move forward, talking to each other, understanding that, and pushing, you know, agendas away, and everybody talk to each other without passing judgment.
Salute.
Absolutely.
I'm putting Bosco channel in the chat. I want to thank everybody for coming to the show. I appreciate you guys. Dark Council will be back in 2 weeks. That's how we do it. We skip a week, and then we'll go live a week. We appreciate you so much. And guess what, ladies and gentlemen? Guess what, ladies and gentlemen? Bye.
So you know what this...
Fader, what is you looking at? You were staring hard at the camera just then.
Oh, I'm sorry.
What
are
you just looking at, bro?
You're standing on...
You killed Luke, you bastard!
The backlash.
This is the Last Jedi all over again.
You can't do
it. I told
it.
My son, I said, boy, watch the stream tonight, boy. Watch the stream. You're going to be proud of your old man. And what does he see? What does he see?
I don't hear it now.
Yeah, look at you. It was Fox's own.
It wasn't
time.
Me.
Stand up. How's that happen? You can't come back from that.
I think y'all did this on purpose to make me hope tonight. Just so y'all could do all of this.
Abu, you did it. It was beautiful. I'm sorry.
You did it, Abu. What you talking about?